This is CNT Sports. I have the distinct honor to introduce you, Chris Miller from WRHI. Thanks so much for stopping by.
Appreciate it, James. Thank you.
As of right now, South Point is underway with a big WRHI Football City USA kickoff. Real quickly, what led to the birth of this big kickoff?
Well, about 5 years ago, people started approaching us to bring back an old preseason event. The Herald had put one on, and we started having some conversations with the school district. And about 2 years ago, we finally said, this is something they want to do, we want to do, and put it together. 9 months ago, we put together the agreement to set up to what we hope is an annual tradition coming back.
Give us like a sort of a preview for each team. First off, the South Point Stallions. Can they four-peat a state championship this season?
Well, no doubt they can four-peat. They have more talent than maybe any team in the state of South Carolina. It all starts Darion Kendrick. He is a stud committed to Clemson, going to play wide receiver there, but he's dangerous when the football's in his hands, so you have to have him playing quarterback. Defensively, they have guys like Eli Adams, receiver and Stephen Gilmore, who is going to make his decision, but he's got four or five offers. I mean, they have maybe six or seven Division I seniors on this team, so the talent is there. The tough thing for Coach Heron and his squad is keeping them focused, keeping them hungry. That's the difficult thing. They've won three, so sometimes, well, it can get easy now. No, it's never easy, because you get to playoffs, one, and you're done, and especially when you look at their schedule.
Which game stands out to you?
Well, I mean, first you got to look at Northwestern. That's been a one-possession game for, I think going back 7, 8 years. 2 years ago, they lost in overtime on a missed two-point conversion. The year before, missed two-point conversion as well. They got the best of the Trojans last year. So even though South Point's probably the better team this year, at least at the start of the season, you can expect to be a close game. Also, that Buford and Shelby game. Buford is a national power, having to go down there. I mean, it's a small college, basically. And then Shelby, they've won, I think, three or four consecutive 3A state championships up in North Carolina.
Taking a look at the Rock Hill Bearcats, they seem to be under a sort of a youth movement under Coach Bubba Pittman. What do you see from the Bearcats this season?
You know, Rock Hill, you're right, a very young football team. I think they return 8 total starters. The good thing for them at the quarterback position, Logan McFadden got a lot of playing time last year, so he is, without a doubt, he seems to be the starting guy this season, and he's got that season under his belt. And in an air raid offense, when the quarterback gets it, you're going to win a lot of football games, because it is based premeditated in a lot of what the decisions the quarterback makes prior to the snap.
Taking a closer look at the schedule, what are your first impressions?
The big game I see, two games to note. You've got York and South Point right there going on the road to York. That's York's season opener. Also, the Stallions, this is a game last year. Rock Hill led late in the fourth quarter. South Point scored the final 16 points to win that game. And then Boiling Springs, this is a team that made the state championship last year. When Rock Hill played them, they played them well, and people were like, well, you know, is Boiling Springs really that good? Found out they're a pretty good football team as they made it to the state championship. So I think that the 25th, 1st, and 8th, those three games are key games. You can really tell what the Bearcats are going to be this season.
Finally, taking a look at the Northwestern Trojans and second-year head coach David Pierce, what do they need to do to take the next step?
Well, we talked about with Rock Hill about a youth movement. There's going on at Northwestern as well. They got to replace Mr. Football, a Shrine Bowler, quarterback Gage Maloney. This was a guy, the first ever Mr. Football at Northwestern, which is tough to believe. So that's big shoes to fill. Dustin Noller, of course, getting a look at that to start things off, but there's some other quarterbacks that will be in the competition as well. So I think for Northwestern, it's a feeling out process in tonight's game as well as their first few games, because keep in mind, non-region play doesn't matter. There's no point systems left. It all comes down to how you do in region.
Taking a closer look at the first five games for Northwestern, what are your impressions there?
Two teams we're going to see tonight that are facing off, South Point and Burns. Those are the two biggies to me, going to South Point to start the season. Then home against Burns. Those have always been some great games. At Spartanburg, also one you want to take a look on. The Vikings were a young team last year, nearly beat a very veteran Northwestern team last year. So having to go to Wofford College and play the Vikings, that can sometimes cause problems. That's a big stadium to play in. A lot of young players from Northwestern. So probably those three games.
That's awesome. Chris, thanks so much for coming by.
Appreciate it, James. Thank you, buddy.
And we'll toss it back to the news desk.
All right, thanks, James and Chris. Again, to see a preview of the Rock Hill area teams in action this Friday night, you can still make it out to District 3 Stadium for the WRHI Football City USA kickoff. South Point's game has already started. Rock Hill's game versus Huff starts at 7. Northwestern will close out the night against Union County at 9 p.m. Also taking place in Chester County. A number of our teams are playing some preseason games down there. We will have a crew at that series of games as well. We'll have a full recap for you on Monday. Have a good weekend.